Hey there everyone, I kind of wanted to show off a little something on how to get two keyboards to work for two players on a single PC, for just about any Touhou multiplayer game. Something I haven't quite heard anyone accomplish yet, and I'm here to finally shed some light on how. It all comes down to a new program I found called Keyboard Splitter, and I'll leave any download links in the description below for you to download. Okay, so first things first, if you're running Windows 7 or an older OS, you're gonna have to download the 360 controller drivers. If you have Windows 8 or 10, you probably don't have to worry about this. So once that's done, just go ahead and make a new folder, name it Keyboard Splitter or something like that. Download the archive that I put down in the description into the new folder and just extract the files from there. And you can just delete the archive afterwards once you're done. So open Keyboard Splitter for the first time, and this is just a one-time thing. It's gonna ask you to install some drivers in there. Just keep on hitting yes or okay, whatever shows up a few times. I have my Windows in another monitor, so that's why you're seeing me constantly drag all those windows, but just keep on clicking OK, and then once you get to a point where it'll ask you to reboot, just hit yes and come back once you're done resetting your PC. So now that you restarted your PC, you should be able to launch Keyboard Splitter normally from here on in. So go ahead and open it, and the first thing you're probably going to want to do is on the left side of the window, on the slot count, you're gonna change that to 1, and keep the block chosen keyboards checked. So what that does is basically just keep that keyboard in check once you start the emulation. So next thing you're gonna do from here on in is detect the keyboard that you want emulated. So click on the little box right there and just press any key on the keyboard that you want emulated. So next, this is where the presets come in. You could be able to select any of the Touhou presets that I made that was included in the archive earlier. And what those presets contain is basically just the defaults. You can just change whatever you want from there if you really want to. If not, if you're used to just using the default keys, go ahead and just keep it as is. And don't forget to uncheck the bind button A to keyboard, because what that'll do is it'll sometimes count, you know, A and enter as one key if you hit enter. So yeah, go ahead and start the emulation, and from there on in, you're free to open up the game that you want. Also, right here, I'm basically just testing out the inputs while I'm waiting for the game to load. So once I get that to load, okay, so here, all we have to do is just go to profile, and I already made a new profile for myself just to test out the keyboard config for the emulated gamepad. For the emulated gamepad. So you could just select it and just map it as you would normally. So you see on the right, on the bottom right, all those inputs are made from my second keyboard, while the keyboard overlay you see on the bottom left, that's essentially my normal keyboard that I have connected to the PC. So they are now detected separately. And here on in, I'm just basically just getting a feel for both keyboard and the emulated keyboard. And here I am just testing the lag by just pressing both keyboards as close to the same time as possible. And I don't really seem to notice any noticeable lag between the two. So just as a fair warning, I'm not a dedicated keyboard player, so I'm just trying to test inputs as best as humanly possible, so just a fair warning. But yeah, everything I've done, it seems okay. I'm able to do some confirms here and there. And yeah, that just pretty much covers the demonstration part. Oh, and one more thing. Make sure once you change from one game to another to make sure you stop to and then change your preset from there. Also, if you need to, like I said before, change a keybind for the emulated preset, just click on the little box right next to it and then just press a button and you're good to go. Just make sure to save it before moving on.